Hey, what's up? Robert here from Robert's Productions, and today I'm going to show you how to fold up your text here in Photoshop. So, let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is go to File, New, and let's create a new window here. 720 by 480 works for me. Click OK. And I'm actually going to drag this background on over to my new window here. If you want to learn more about creating this background or even download the project file, go ahead and check out the description for that link. First thing I'm going to do is create some text. So I'm going to come over here to the text tool and click and type in an F. I'm going to change the color of this F here just a little bit. I'm actually going to change it to kind of an off-white, maybe a little bit more. Alright, so that looks good. Now, I am going to Control T this and rotate it here a little bit. Hit Enter on your keyboard. Now that we've got that done, we're going to go ahead and duplicate this layer by clicking and dragging it down to the new layer icon. We got this new F copy. We can drag this down below this layer, it doesn't really matter, it's a copy anyway, and we can make this not visible at all to the naked human eye, okay? We don't want that to be visible. Now that we have this F here, we're going to want to do something to it so we can modify it. I'm going to right-click and click Rasterize Type. Now that we have Rasterize Type done, we can modify it a little bit more by going to the Polygonal Lasso Tool. So if you want, you can go to the shed where you keep your lasso and instead of rounding up some sheep or goat, whichever ones they do, look for the one that looks like this, polygonal lasso, okay? Look for that one. I don't know if that would be made out of metal or... Moving on, let's go ahead and create a little clip of this text. Just like that. Make that selection. Bam! Okay. Now I am going to hit Control J. Control J. And you can see we have that little selection. But when I hide it, you know, we still have it on this F. So I'm going to rename some things here. I'm going to name this left corner. And then that's just going to be F. All right. I'm going to select my F layer and hold down Control. Click my left corner so that's selected. Then I'm going to hit Alt. Now I always say hit, so I mean I want you to hit it like, okay, and then hit the mask tool here. Hit that, and now it's masked. But we have a little bit of a problem. You can see here, there's a line there. Where'd that come from? Why is that there? We're going to click on our new mask on this F here. Hope you're still able to follow me because I feel like I've just rambled on and done so many things by now. Go to the brush tool, change your foreground color to white, and fill this in. Fill it in with what? News. Okay, now that we got that filled in with news, with white, we can go to our left corner, hit Control T. Or why don't we just go to Edit, Free Transform, right click, Distort, click on our top corner here, bring this in just like that, that looks good, hit Enter on your keyboard, and we come up with this new problem. What are these lines? So we can go back to our layer mask here, change the foreground color to black, go to the brush tool, and erase that out. Alright, now that we got that erased, we want to kind of imagine that the light is shining down from this right corner here. And we can do that by creating shadows and highlights. I want to highlight this left corner. So I'm going to go to the dodge tool, range at highlights, exposure 100%, and just highlight that. Highlight that. All right, so now it's highlighted. Looks a little bit more realistic, but we're not done. I'm going to go ahead and repeat this process to create another fold, except this time on this corner of the F. Now that that's selected, remember, hit Control J while our F layer is selected, Control J. select the F layer, and let's rename this layer to right corner. Control click on that right corner while the text layer is selected. Make sure our layer mask is chosen. Black is chosen, the brush tool, and just take that out. Just like that. Control D. And then you can always go back to your white, fill this in. And then there you go. Now we can go to our right corner, edit, free transform, right click, distort, bring this in as well. You can hold down control so it doesn't snap or turn off snapping options in your settings view snap. Make sure our layer mask is selected again. Back foreground to black and just erase those little lines. Now the light's shining from this way, so I think we're gonna have a little bit of a shadow here in this paper fold. So right corner, choose the burn tool with the highlights and exposure set and just burn that up. So there you go, there's some basics so far of folding your text. You're just gonna have to do that with every letter. We're still not done. For extra credit, extra points, we can add some things. We can add our background shadow. So this layer right here that we hid before, we can make that visible again. We can change the color of this layer or the text to black. Right click, rasterize type. Edit, free transform. Right click, distort. Bring this in. Bring this out. Looking good, hit enter. Let's go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, add a blur at around 5, click OK, bring the opacity down to around 30% or so, and there you go. For even more bonus points, you can go ahead and go to webgraphics.net, the link's in the description, to download 12 high-res paper textures absolutely free. So why not just do that now? Then drag that paper texture into Photoshop. Make sure it's all the way at the top. Right click, rasterize layer, image adjustments. I don't know why it's not showing. Desaturate. It's not showing to you, but that's what I clicked. We can even go to Control T. Hold down Shift and Alt. Bring this down a little bit. Hit Enter. Select our F here. Our little F layer. Control Shift I to invert the selection, delete Control D, and change the blending mode of the paper layer from normal to multiply, in which you can't see as well, but we're going to multiply it. And there you have your text, finally. But we're still not done. We're going to make sure our first layer is selected. Hold down Shift, select all of our layers. I like to right-click, duplicate layers, click OK, Control E to merge them all. You can hide all these. And now we have everything on one layer. Now we can go to Filter, Render, Lighting Effects. Add some lighting effects here, just like this. Widen it up a bit. Click OK, and there you have your text. Folded up with some lighting effects done in Photoshop. I know it's a long process for just one letter, so you can use this sparingly. So by the time you get done with the first letter and you see all the other letters you gotta do, you're probably gonna just wanna spell that out. You know what it says. So there you go. Remember, you can check out the tutorial and even download this background by clicking the link in the description. You can follow me on Twitter at Roberts Productions. Visit the site robertsproductions.net. Questions, robert@robertsproductions.net. And subscribe to this channel for more weekly tutorials just like this one. So I hope this helped. Thank you for watching. And if you made it to the end, you just won a golden star. Take care.